Hallelujah, nothing but the word. And sometimes, you know, the strangest thing that happened, but this sister, that was her only area that she really didn't understand how your diet relates to your ability to overcome chronic ailments, especially when a whole lot of things have occurred in the past that you can't overcome if you don't really, at some point, begin to what? Do it right. And then in order to go back and to what? To repair, then that means that you got to do more than just what's enough for right now. You got to go back and make up for all that damage you've done. So that means you have to have some high-powered what? Supplements. Amen. Brother Doug, did you know that there are supplements you can get that you can take two tablets, and these are all in raw form. I mean, this was, you paid dearly for them, but they work. Like two tablets can give you 5 to 9 servings of fresh vegetables and fruit. You can get, I mean, it can be that potent. But I don't talk about that much because people think you're trying to get the money. I don't even bother, but you have to be wise if you really want to overcome a whole lot of things that's going on undercover. But you can overcome every obstacle to your health by what? Someone said, turn right and go straight. Turn right and what? Go straight. Amen. So that's the key. And you know, this sister probably could have been living today, but that was the area that she didn't understand how dietary practices relate to her ability to overcome chronic ailments that have been established way, way back in her past from eating things that were not good for her. You know, I don't know how I got on all this. Amen. All right, but I'm gonna give you another illustration. Is that a sister used to come here, that preached Sister England. How many remember her? Yeah. Amen. We were really trying to get them to get off of this Atkins diet. Because you eat all this protein, and all the protein diet. And you don't have no vegetables and fruit, stuff like that. But, you know, many times when people are knowing, it's very difficult for me to try to explain to her how important it is for her to eat 80% raw and supplements and things like that when she had all these gifts working. Y'all know how she just called people out? It was very difficult. And sometimes when people are very gifted like that, they feel that their anointing will overshadow anything that they are doing wrong in the natural. But it won't. There's a natural sign of life. That's the reason the Bible said, feed me with food that's what convenient for me. And that's the reason Daniel, if you go down the list, all of these great men of God that lived a long time, that were very powerful, most of them were men that what? Were very restrained. Elijah, how many remember Elijah? 40 days on the strength of what? One meal. Is that right? How did Elijah die? When did he die? He didn't. He was caught up in a whirlwind. And somebody said that the three witnesses in Revelation are Elijah and Moses. All right, agree, brother?
Yes.
All right, Elijah and Moses. So he didn't even die. But he got so close to heaven. Amen. Until God just what? God just took him. He was living in that zone where the anointing just came and zapped him up. Amen. So that is a very important thing, and I believe that when people really understand, and that's one of the things that we're trying to get over in this ministry, is that we focus on teaching people how to eat right. And I have a book that's full of information on take charge of your life. It tells about all the different things that's bad for you. Amen. The five killers. Amen. White flour. And write it down. White flour. And a whole, amen, you can go down the list. Hydrogenated what? Oils. Hydrogenated oils. Y'all know what hydrogenated oils are? Y'all know what that is? That's the oils that you fry your chicken with. Amen. You should, so you shouldn't be frying. You should be what? Baking it. All right? All right. Then you have the sugar, which, oh God, y'all know sugar is just a 14 different chemical processes it goes through. 14 different chemical processes to make it pretty and white. Raw sugar, that's the candy back whenever we use it, raw sugar. But it's not white, it's kind of, you know, have a brownish looking. Okay, white sugar is a real killer. Diabetes today is raging. Man, one out of every, so many people, 13 people up there, they have diabetes. Okay, and Japan, let me just say this. Japan, speaking about water, how important water is, I think the film Friday night convinced y'all that water is very, very, all water is not created equal. Over in Japan, the number one in longevity, number one in health, number one in whatever else that pertains to health. But they are the longest living people, the Hanzo people, the close second. And in Japan, one out of every five homes have the type of water that we've been talking about here. One out of five homes have them. They have them in 265 hospitals. And I was reading, I was looking at some of those DVDs the other night. People that have chronic ailments, their feet are rotting off, and they have diabetes, and a lot, part of their feet, they just come and just soak them in that water. And they were about to cut one man's foot off, amputated. And he soaked it in that water, they took him in the hospital. That's how they treat a lot of patients there, by giving them alkaline water, alkaline ionized water. And that's what we're trying to get people to start eating, more what? Alkaline food. So that heals them, and they're number one in health. And the Hanzo people live to be 120, 150, but they basically eat the same way, and they what, have the same type of water. Here in America, one out of every 18,000 families have this kind of water. And we rate number 38 when it comes to health. So you can see that what we're talking about in terms of an alkaline diet, alkaline water, everything, see, alkaline diet is very, very important. That's the reason the water works so well, because this water that runs over rocks and sand is like the waters come down from the glaciers on the big mountains, where when the rocks run over certain rocks and things, it puts a nutrient in it that helps to alkaline the body. And that's the reason why the machine, the only one in the world that's certified as a piece of medical equipment. And it has plates equivalent to the rocks and things that water runs on, where people can flock to and get the type of water that will be alkaline, that will build their bodies up so that their bodies will heal itself. See, that's the whole thing. The water doesn't heal, food doesn't heal, but it builds your body up to a point where your body can what? Heal. The body can what? Heal itself. Okay, so that is a little bit of wisdom this morning that we're just giving you. And as a result of teaching this way for 35 years now, you know, I know that there have been people that have passed away in this ministry. When I look back at people that have heard this teaching behind it and that it has adhered to it for a long period of time, I would say I don't remember hardly anybody dying prematurely that were under this ministry for a long period of time, that did what we told them to do, and that really watched their diet, fasted and prayed, and really, we believe in exercise too. Is that right? It takes all of that in order for you to what? Reach the point of optimal health. Amen. Praise God. So that's a testimony. Sometimes every time you look around, people are bearing fault. As long as your diet is alkaline, as long as your blood is alkaline, sickness and diseases can't exist. That's the reason why we're trying to get you from what? Asset form and stuff. Y'all understand what I'm saying? The asset form and stuff. Y'all believe what? Meat? What else? Bread, sweets, pop, junk food, potato chips, peanut butter and crackers, jelly and peanut butter. And get you over here. Like brother, talk to Brother Billy. Tell him to bring you some peaches. Oh, them peaches, man, them peaches. Oh, Lord. I can put some protein on them peaches. Y'all said, we're messing them up now. Messing them up now. That's what I'm saying, that another thing that we have practiced for a long time, and I don't know of any sickness or disease can stay in your body when you really have the raw stuff, the plant-based protein. I'm a person that believes in like these soy shakes every day. I use rice drain milk. See, that's good because it's made from brown rice. Rice drain milk. Okay. And then I put protein, soy protein in it. Then I stir it up. And I put some cinnamon in it. And I sweeten it with apple juice. I got organic apple juice in my refrigerator right now, organic apple juice. That sweetens it up, and I drink it. Is it good? You better believe it's good. Because that's the thing that retards the growth of cancer. Or turns it around. Plant-based protein is what you want. I'm not saying you can't ever eat meat, because how many like bacon? Yeah, you're gonna raise your hand now. I eat bacon. I eat turkey bacon. Turkey bacon is good. I like turkey sausage and stuff like that. But I don't eat that every day. But even if I eat that, I take me some protein. I said, I don't know what's all in this stuff. I just want to be saved. What did I do? I just take me some protein. Amen. That's the reason why we want to have an addition to this church. And we're going to have a big room. We're going to have a nutritional place where y'all can come and get all your vitamins. And vitamins, I'm just talking today, just not most of them, y'all even know, none of us hardly know what vitamins to get. When you get the first place you think about vitamins, you think about what? Atkins, Whole Foods, the place where they got all of these thousands and thousands of what? Vitamins, and nobody there, not even them, know about these vitamins. They know about some of them. So, the safest way, I'm gonna give you some counsel this morning. The safest way to build your body up, all the stuff that's missing in your diet, the best thing to do is to try to get vitamins. You know, like a multivitamin, multimineral that has all of the whole gamut of nutrients that your body needs in order to sustain itself. But the problem is that you don't know whether these vitamins are good or bad, where they came from, how they were raised, or whether they were supervised, whether they use chemicals on it. You just don't know none of that. So what do? You go to the company. See, the Lord just showed me this many, many years ago. When I went to Carolina a few years ago, I talked to several hundred, about 100 pastors at one time, 4 or 5 days straight. And I just shared with them this simple stuff like this. And I followed them to the lunch room, dinner, and boy, they had 3 or 4 different meats. No, let me see, what kind of vegetable? They had some kind of canned vegetable, 1 or 2 things. And they had 4 or 5 different kinds of cakes and things. And boy, I mean, they just, they enjoy themselves. No salad. No salad. Okay, so you gotta find a way to make up for all of these missing ingredients. So you go to a company, amen. Some of y'all gonna accuse me today of just, amen. I'm not preaching the word today, am I? Okay, you go. That's what I told. That's what I tell everybody. You go to the company that has a reputation of growing their